In this video, I'll be showing you the best SteelSeries Sonar settings for 2025. These are my updated settings to help you hear footsteps easier, make music sound better, and improve your microphone quality. Start by opening the SteelSeries GG software. If you don't already have it, then I'll include a link in the description. Sign into your account, then select Sonar from the side. Go to the game panel and click the box just above the slider. Then select the device you listen to gameplay with. Go to the chat panel and select the device you use for chat or Discord. This may be the same as your gameplay. Go to Media and select the device you use for watching movies or content. Then set Aux to the device you use for listening to music. Head across again and set Mic to the microphone that you use. All of these options can be customized individually, allowing you to adjust how your gameplay, chat, media, music, and microphone sound, regardless of if they're the same device. Make sure the master volume slider is turned up, then go to the top and select Game. As every game is different, you may want to adjust your audio settings to your liking. However, for this video, I will be showing you the best settings that I have found to work across multiple games. Click on the preset menu to open it, then go down and select COD Black Ops 6. Head up and click the cross. Open the preset options by clicking the three dots under the preset name. Then choose to duplicate. Give your preset a name. I'll be calling mine Gaming. Then click the duplicate button. Click the star icon and the preset will be added to your favorites bar on the side. You can use this to quickly switch between presets when needed. Go down to the sliders beneath the equalizer graph, then set bass to negative 0.5, voice to 1.2, and treble to 0.5. Go to the graph and select the last marker on the right. Select the gain box, then type in 7 and press enter. Select the frequency box, then type in 9000 and press enter. Select the Q box, then type 1.3 and press enter. Now go all the way to the left and select the first marker. Select the gain box, then set it to negative 1 and press enter. Select the frequency, then enter 40 and press enter. Select the Q box, then type in 0.5 and press enter. If you prefer to have more bass when gaming, then you can increase the bottom slider slightly. I'll be leaving mine as is. Scroll down and turn on spatial audio. Select headphone mode if you use a headset for gaming, or speaker mode if you use speakers. Move tuning all the way to performance and set distance to 75. These are the best spatial audio settings that I have found. However, I find it easier to hear footsteps with spatial audio turned off. I recommend playing with spatial audio enabled and disabled to find what works best for you. Go down and set volume boost to 0 unless your audio is too quiet. If it is, then it's best to adjust your audio through your PC or audio device itself before increasing the gain. Turn off smart volume, then head back to the top and switch to the chat settings. Expand the preset menu, then select flat or balanced. These options will give a good natural sound. However, if all of your friends have good microphones, then you can try broadcast. Click the cross to close, then scroll down. Turn on clearcast. This will automatically reduce background noise and clear up the audio from other people's microphones. I like to move the slider to about 43. While this does a decent job, you may run into issues where a friend's microphone may be cutting in and out. If this is the case, then you can move the slider further to the left or use manual settings. To use manual settings, turn off clearcast, then go down to the noise reduction settings. Enable background and impact, then set background to 0.35 and impact to 0.50. Turn on noise gate, then set it to about negative 40. If people's voices are cutting in and out, then move the slider to the left. And if there's too much background noise, then move the slider to the right. Turn off the compressor setting, then go back to the top and switch to the media settings. Open the preset menu. Select the Movie Immersion preset, then close the menu. Go to the sliders below the equalizer, then set bass to 3, voice to 3, and treble to 2. Scroll down and turn on the spatial audio setting. Choose if you're using headphones or speakers, then set the top slider to negative 2.5 and the distance slider to 70. Go down and set the volume boost to 0 and turn off smart volume. Go to the top and switch to the Aux tab. Open the preset menu, then select Music Punchy. Close the preset menu. Head to the equalizer sliders, then set bass to 0.2, voice to 5, and treble to 2. Turn on spatial audio, then select if you're using headphones or speakers. Set the performance immersion slider to negative 1.2 and the distance to 70. Again, set the volume boost to 0 and turn off smart volume. These are my favorite settings that work well for most music genres, especially rap. However, you can experiment with other presets if you don't like how this sounds. Also, remember remember that you can save presets as favorites that you can switch between at any time. Select Mic from the top menu. Open the preset menu. The best option will vary depending on your voice. For a male voice, the less nasal, deep voice, and broadcast low pitch presets typically work well. However, for a female, the broadcast low pitch and clarity low pitch options are good. I like to use deep voice. Turn on Clearcast, then set the slider to about 45. If you have issues with your microphone cutting in and out, then try moving your microphone closer to your mouth. If you're using a headset microphone or moving closer doesn't work, then move the slider to the left. Alternatively, turn off Clearcast. Go down to the noise reduction settings and turn on the background and impact options. Set background to 0.40 and impact to 0.50. Turn on noise gate, then set it to negative 40. Again, if your mic cuts in and out, then move the slider to the left. And if there's too much background noise, then move the slider slightly to the right. Go down and turn off the compressor setting. Then go to the top and test your microphone. Press the record button and talk, then press the stop button. Press the play button to listen to your voice, then make any needed adjustments. If you are using an application that has inbuilt noise reduction like Discord, then your sonar settings may cause issues. If this is the case, you will want to turn off the noise reduction settings for other apps. To fix issues on Discord, open the user settings using the gear icon. Select voice and video from the side, then find the input sensitivity heading. Turn on the automatically determined input sensitivity setting. If there are still issues, then turn off the option and drag the slider all the way to the left. Go back to the SteelSeries Sonar and switch to the mixer settings. When the audio is being played from another application, it will show up in the bottom boxes. You can drag the application to another box to change which audio mix is used. Typically, you will want your browser to be under Media and Spotify to be under the Aux option. If you can move the application, then you will need to change the audio device in the application settings. For this example, I'll be using Discord. Set your input device to the SteelSeries Sonar microphone option and the output device to SteelSeries Sonar chat. For games, be sure to select SteelSeries Sonar gaming. Use the sliders to adjust the volume of each audio device individually, or adjust the master slider to adjust them all at once. You can also mute a device by clicking the speaker icon at the bottom. Close, and you will now have the best SteelSeries Sonar settings. Consider leaving a like if you found the video helpful.